Welcome to the presentation of our paper, Kaboom! Visually Exploring Latency Measurements for XR. So, what is latency? It is defined as a delay in a system. In XR, we most often look at the motion to photon latency, which is the time between a motion which gets tracked, fed into simulation to render the next image, which is then shown on the screen. Latency becomes a problem if it is too big. Like, if you walk in VR, see that there is a wall approaching, but your virtual image lags behind. So, the wall is closer than you anticipated. Or, also unpleasant, latency can make you sick. To know that latency is too high, we need to measure it. There are many approaches, some easier to conduct than others, some more precise. Our paper provides a visual overview of how to measure latency. The visual representation allows to quickly understand the concept of an approach and compare similarities and differences between approaches. Let's dive into some selected approaches to understand them. To measure motion to photon latency, you need to observe a motion and its respective counterpart on a screen. You either do this with one camera, or you observe the motion and its effects with two different synchronized devices. The most simple approach is frame counting, as described by Hay et al. They move a tracked wand in front of a screen. The screen shows the virtual counterpart. A camera records the scene. The video is analyzed to find when the wand overlaps a line on the screen and when the virtual wand overlaps the same line on the screen. The time that has passed between the events is the motion to photon latency. Alas, frame counting is limited by the camera's temporal and spatial resolution. Sign fitting overcomes problems caused by a lacking camera resolution by using the predictability of a pendulum. Steed attaches a tracked object to a pendulum, and its position is rendered on the screen. A camera records both the real and the virtual pendulum. The positions are extracted via thresholding. He fits a sine curve each to correct measurement inaccuracies. The motion to photon latency can be calculated from the phase difference. Alas, sine fitting is limited. For example, when using virtual reality head-mounted displays, the screen's image is distorted by lenses, preventing a clear recorded image if a camera needs to record both the real motion and the screen. See our paper to find more illustrations of latency measurement approaches. We were asked in the reviews why we chose the visual style. We researched latency in XR systems and how to measure it. Part of it is to read scientific papers of other researchers. Remembering what each paper is about becomes harder the more there are. So you write notes. The problem is how to write notes to remember, because many papers means many notes. One thing is special with those papers. There is always some physical apparatus in the center of attention. We created sketches which help to see how the approaches are similar to one another and how they differ. The sketches allow to compare, sort, and categorize latency measurement approaches. The visual overview helped us in our research, and we want to make it available to others to help them as well. It is important to note that this paper is no substitution for an in-depth written literature overview. It is more an addition to the more textual treatment. It may ease entering the topic for scholars not yet familiar with it, and we believe that this topic is important for many.